Thank you. Here's Lucas.
Hi, everybody. Just wanted to give you guys a 5-minute countdown. No need to stop talking, just 5 minutes, and we'll get going. Okay? Thank you. Thank you. All right, folks, let's lock in and have a wonderful time together. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, scholarship and bursary donors, esteemed faculty members, proud parents, guardians, extended family, and everyone who's watching on the live stream. The big day has finally arrived, and it's going to be amazing. Let's get this party started. Thank you. My name is Craig Lucas, teacher here at Bow Valley, and I'm incredibly grateful and honored that this graduating class has given me the privilege of their Master of Ceremonies, your MC, if you will. First off, I would like to begin by asking Mr. Anton Kukwitz Bearspaw to come to the stage to do a land acknowledgement. As part of our ongoing commitment at Bow Valley High School and Rocky View Schools to truth and reconciliation, it is important for us all to take a moment and acknowledge and recognize all the Indigenous peoples whose footprints have marked these lands from time immemorial. Together, we can learn and honor the ways of knowing of Indigenous peoples and all peoples for future generations.
Ambulwa Stitch. My name is Anton Bearspaw. Rocky View Schools is situated on Treaty 7 territories, home of the Southern Dakota First Nations, the Satina First Nations, the Blackfoot Confederacy, and the Métis. Eastnish.
Thank you, Anton. Well, parents, guardians, extended family members, and friends, you did it. This day of celebration and a momentous occasion to mark the years of hard work you have put in behind the scenes, like the early morning practices, to the late night games, weekend tournaments in some small town that no one's ever heard of, the fundraising drives, the band concerts and trips, the endless hours spent at the dinner table, studying for those math and science exams, but never social. Okay, I see. And the constant hounding you did to make sure that they were keeping up with their assignments, you did that. Your unending support and love, constant encouragement, and the occasional kick in the backside has culminated in the celebration we are about to witness. So take a minute and savor it. You've earned it. Before we get going and bring in the stars of the show, just a quick overview of what's going to happen and some housekeeping. Please make sure that your ringers on your phone are turned off or silent. Same goes for those notifications, you know, you don't want to get a TikTok in the middle or an Instagram post or those terrible Snapchats. In a few short minutes, we'll be bringing in the graduates. After they come in and get seated, we will have the singing of O Canada. We ask that if you are able, please stand and remove your hats. We will also do this when we do the honor song. So let's get started and get right into it. But first, there are some amazing people that have not taken their seats yet. These individuals make coming to work a joy and are truly extraordinary. Working with them over the last few years has been incredibly rewarding. So, please join me in welcoming the Bow Valley High School staff. And please, keep it up, keep it up. They deserve it. A vuvuzela, here we go. What a great looking bunch. Is that Mr. Baugh? Wow. Man, does that guy have style. Need to take some pointers from later from that guy. Woo. The rest of you look great as well, so don't worry. Okay? And I know we clean up well as a staff. But they're not the real stars. They're coming. So please join me in welcoming this high school graduating class of Bow Valley of 2023, led by Ms. Katie Cahoon and Mr. Taylor Grant. Okay. Please welcome Constables Nathan Moore and Clayton Jalinas for the presentation of the flag. Please stand for the singing of our national anthem, being performed by Miss Lucy Williamson, as she is known to the most of the school, Anne of Green Gables. Thank you, Lucy. So, I know, graduates, standing in that little hallway there was painful. Yeah, painful is right. So, we're not going to try to keep you here any longer than we have to. So, with that being said, I'd like to now call upon Rocky View trustee for Ward 6, Ms. Fiona Gilbert, to come up and say a few words.
Good afternoon, graduates. I'm here to tell you that the hardest part of today is done, and that's trying to find your way through all of these people and find your seats. So well done. Good on you. It is my pleasure and my privilege to be here this afternoon. What a glorious day for a graduation. And I'm here representing the Rocky View Schools Board of Trustees as we recognize these young people here in front of us and the achievements of the class of 2023 for Bow Valley High School. Now, grads, I don't know if you've read your grad quote. Hopefully you have. I read it as I prepared for today. And your grad quote starts, "Never give up when encountered by a challenge." And all of you here, sitting here today, are examples of this in action. You are here today because you met each and every one of the challenges head on and you did not give up. Maybe some days you wanted to, I'm sure you felt that, but you didn't. And hey, even a worldwide pandemic couldn't keep you guys down. So congratulations. Graduating high school is an important milestone, and it's so important, in fact, that all of these people around you have come here today to celebrate and to honor you. And yes, individual people and individual families are here to celebrate individual students, but we are here collectively, and we are sharing in this time and this space, and we are celebrating you as a community. So grads, as you walked into this space a few minutes ago and tried to find your seat and all of that, I hope you took the opportunity to look around you. Look at all the people who are here today with you. This is your community, and this is your village. And these are the people who have individually and collectively helped you get where you are today. And I can promise you that they will continue to be there for you when needed. We as this community have had the privilege of watching you grow into strong, courageous, caring, intelligent, and awesome young people that you are. And we know that you are not done yet. Your future is bright, and Rocky View Schools is grateful to have been part of your learning journey. So graduates, all the best to you from the Board of Trustees for continued success wherever your path leads you. And I wish you many good days and bad days and worst days and best days, as it is all of these days that help shape you into the person that you are and the person that you will become. So families, friends, staff, and guests, please join me in congratulating the Bow Valley High School Class of 2023.
Thank you, Ms. Gilbert, for those kind words. Next, please join me in welcoming the Associate Superintendent of Learning, Ms. Lori Meyer, to say a few words.
Good afternoon, proud parents, Bow Valley High staff, and most importantly, this extraordinary graduating class of Bow Valley High School. I'm honored to bring greetings to you from the senior executive team at Rocky View. Today, excuse me, marks a remarkable milestone in your lives. Your resilience, dedication, and unwavering spirit have brought you to this memorable day. Throughout your years in school, you've faced countless challenges. From the learning load to the demands of extracurricular activities, you've encountered moments that have pushed you to your limits. But here you are, ready to embrace the next chapter of your lives. Today, I want to emphasize the importance of never giving up when faced with these challenges. Going along with the theme and sort of to tag on to what Ms. Gilbert said, remember that good days bring happiness. These are the days when everything seems to fall into place, when success comes effortlessly and joy fills our hearts. Cherish these moments, for they remind us of the fruits of our hard work and dedication. As you well know, life is not a never-ending stream of good days. Bad days give us experience. They are the ones that test our patience, resilience, and strength. They might be filled with setbacks, disappointments, and even failure. But remember, it's during these difficult times that we learn the most about ourselves. Embrace these experiences, for they shape us into stronger individuals, ready to tackle whatever comes our way. The worst days give us lessons. These are the days when it feels like the world is against us, when everything that can go wrong does go wrong. These are the days that can push us to our breaking point. Within the darkness of these moments, there lies invaluable wisdom. It is in our darkest hours that we discover our true character, our ability to persevere, and our capacity to rise above adversity. And finally, the best days give us memories. These are the days that we'll cherish forever. The friendships formed, the victories achieved, and the milestones celebrated. Days not unlike today. They are the culmination of hard work, dedication, and resilience. They serve as reminders that the challenges we faced were all worth it. As you leave the school and embark on new adventures, treasure these memories, for they will provide strength and inspiration as you face future challenges. So, grads, as you step out into the world beyond the walls of the school, remember the journey you've taken. Reflect on the good days that brought you happiness, the bad days that gave you experience, the worst days that taught you lessons, and the best days that gave you memories. Embrace every challenge that comes your way, for it is through perseverance and determination that you discover your true potential. Never give up. Never give up. For within every challenge lies an opportunity for growth. Embrace the difficulties, learn from them, and let them shape you into the remarkable individuals I know you already are. Remember that success is not defined by the absence of challenges. Challenges are everywhere, they're a given, and they're going to happen. But success is defined by your ability to overcome them. As you embark on this new chapter of your lives, carry with you the lessons you've learned and the memories you've made. Believe in yourselves, follow your passions, pursue your dreams relentlessly. I have no doubt that each and every one of you will make a profound impact. And not to detract from the quote or the theme that you've chosen, but to add on to that, I'm going to leave you with another quote. This is written by an ultra marathon runner. His name is Dean Karnazes. It's my personal mantra, and it fits any situation. Run when you can, walk when you have to, crawl if you must, but never, ever give up. Congratulations, class of 2023. Everyone in this room is immensely proud of you. May your future be filled with endless possibilities, and may you always have the courage to never give up. Thank you.
Okay, next, we're going to hear a few words from our fearless leader. I was told that he wanted to drive his Harley Davidson onto the stage like he did at Blue and Gold. He explained to the staff about how cool it would look and how it would really amp up the energy. However, building security was not having that. He was shattered. But I guess he can imitate bike noises as he comes up to the stage. Please welcome your favorite Bow Valley biker principal, Mr. Shane Dempster.
It would have been awesome though, right? Like, great, there's lots of room. No, okay, never mind. Move, sorry. Focus. Good afternoon, families, staff, guests, and most importantly, the class of 23. Each year at Grad, those of us that graduated more than a couple of years ago can reflect on the day in our lives. So I did what any grown man would do, and I called my mommy. She has my yearbooks. I graduated a couple years ago, I don't remember stuff. I asked my mom, who's watching right now online, which is super funny, so your parents still watch you do stuff, just so you know. I said, Mom, what was my grad quote? And she said, life is a highway. I was like, well, that's stupid, and a terrible Tom Cochran reference, but I was 17. But maybe there's some wisdom in that. Graduating from high school is a significant part of your journey, the highway, that is life. It has its turns and bends and hills and bumps and breakdowns and sometimes accidents. But this day is a huge achievement. Whether this part of the journey, the highway, is a step towards more formalized education or a gap year or a world to work, this achievement is one that's not all students attain. As we talked this year about defining what being a Bobcat really meant, we set ourselves on three words: respect, responsibility, and resiliency. Grads of 2023, you embody these words in everything that you do. It was a pleasure to get to know you and watch you strive for success, whether on the court, on the field, or in class, or for some of you, all of the above, which I don't know how you guys did that. I want to leave you some things that I've really tried to keep in mind to guide me to try to be a better person every single day. Never stop learning, whether it's academics, athletics, mechanics, or home repair. Push yourselves to learn more. Show gratitude. You do not achieve this goal, nor will you achieve any goals by yourself. Thank the people that got you here today. Embrace your mistakes. This is where the real learning happens. It may not be fun, and it's gonna hurt, but that's what builds character. Be honest with yourself and those you care about the most. The people that love you the most want what's best for you, even when it doesn't feel like it. Be brave, take risks, not hold my beer, watch this, or Guinness Book of Records daredevil acts, but rather take risks in jobs, in love, and in adventure. Without risk, there really is no reward. Grads of 2023, in the last 4 years of your lives, we've seen a global pandemic, political unrest, and a social context that society has shifted significantly, and you've done nothing but succeed through it all. On behalf of Bow Valley High School, we are so tremendously proud of you. Congratulations.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Dempster. Well, now that we're all settled in, we come to it, the part these guys have all been waiting for. The roast of this graduating class. Before I get started, please keep in mind that this graduating class asked me to do this, okay? I could probably spend the entire 2 hours of this celebration carving my Humanities 30 class, but I do not want to make Rachel Stewart laugh cry even more than she already has. Good to see Andrew Grund finally figure out how to dress himself for this auspicious occasion. Considering his typical attire consists of fashion sweatsuits and white socks pulled up to his knees. You know, Ms. Galloway and I actually dressed up as Andrew this year, and I can tell you that when he saw us, he recognized his own terrible fashion choices instantly. Andrew, thank you for always getting the joke. And as always, go Cats. Oh, great. Cohen Schumlich's here. Did he show up late with Tim Hortons? Never had the distinct privilege of teaching Cohen, but I'm sure he single-handedly made several teachers question their profession. Especially Miss Galloway. I see the twins, Joelle and Jace, are here. This might be the first time they aren't dressed exactly the same. Just kidding, they're always gonna look the same. Michaela Warren and Aaron Welmer, bright students, terrible music choices. These girls spent countless lunch hours in my room, and I'd like to share some advice from their idol, T. Swift. You need to calm down. Angie Long, try not to cry more than once today, but we all know that there are tears of joy and happiness. Ella Kruger and Piper McCormack, you two are the epitome of grace and kindness, and tolerated my antics for 2 whole years in humanities. Those lunch hours are not going to be the same next year. And a huge thank you for all the ice caps you bought me this year. They made the afternoons less stressful. Hennis Patel, you truly embody all the qualities my parents always wished I had. You know, most times, students look to their teachers for motivation and inspiration. I look to Hennis. Seriously, guy's amazing. Katie Robinson, I'm sure you felt quite chuffed when you chose that grad quote. Unfortunately, you forgot the tiny, crucial detail that yearbooks were printed before Galloway's marks were submitted. She's probably glaring at me pretty hard right now. But behind that stern look is a truly kind and thoughtful human. Lauren Akhtemchuk. Yes. And Ashley Oram. You two were robbed of your bromance award by the worst version of the newlyweds game we ever played at Bow Valley. Maybe next year we can add a new category, best womance. Okay, sorry, okay. Great to see Andre Maddox. Andre hails from a faraway, magical land called Florida. Andre loves to be the center of attention. There he is, right there. And would really appreciate if everybody came up to him after and said hello and just wished him the best. That's sarcasm. Anyway. Carson Gessner and Daniel Holt. Chasing you boys around the school has been both exhausting and rewarding. But I definitely got my daily steps in trying to round you two up with so much help from Ms. Smith. I'm so proud of the individuals you have grown into over the last 4 years. Anton Kukwitz Bearspa, thank you for that amazing land acknowledgement. I think you will go down as one of the most universally liked Bow Valley High School students. Such an authentically caring soul, and I truly believe The world would be a better place if we approach life the way Anton does. Whew. This group also has some tremendous athletes. Leighton Boynton's here. Leighton is one of the most genuinely kind individuals you will ever come across. Unless you happen to meet him on the football field, then he's not so kind or gentle. Paula Cuesta, the MVP of our senior boys basketball team. Try not to let the hype of your Bobby Award win go to your head. Zach Gershon Badesha, Ethan Horb, and Marcus Henderson. Rocking some diamonds in the ears, boys, eh? I haven't got to the punchline yet. There must have been a 3-for-1 sale special at Claire's. Just Josh and you boys. It was great to see you boys have a wonderful season this year and look forward to what you're going to do in the future. Then we have Tegan Lord, who's very, very reserved as an individual in school and in the classroom. But get out of her way on the badminton court, lest you end up with a birdie smashed in your face. And then there's Josie Powers. What can I say about Josie that hasn't already been covered by a 10-minute speech at Blue and Gold? Josie is one fierce competitor, and she brings to a close the legacy of the Powers athletes at Bow Valley. We also have some amazing artists in this graduating class. Abigail Thomas, Grace Sylvester, and Natasha Yuremchuk. These exceptional ladies' artwork is actually displayed on the program you were given on the way in. Just incredible talents. Antoni Juliano? Anthony Juliano. Oh. He played a flawless role in this year's production of Anna Green Gables alongside the amazingly talented Lucy Williamson. Give it up, yeah. Anthony's acting was on point, but his pronunciation needs some fine tuning, especially when it comes to Irish names. Remember, Anthony, it's Sinead Byrne. Not Cindy, or as you put it, Sin-E-Ad, B-Earn. Josie was telling you it's Sinead the entire time. Oh, man. Annalisa Julia is here. What a rock star. I've seen Miss McKechnie not talk a lot about the type of student you are before. She is a rock star, okay? Her work in the fashion program this year was exceptional, and I'm sure her parents are thrilled that she saved them a whole bunch of money not buying a grad dress. Okay, maybe that didn't go as well. We also have some talented filmmakers graduating this year, including Logan Vlasblom and Keith Radford. Yeah, Keith! Keith had one of his films featured in a festival, and I cannot wait to see your name on the big screen at Cochrane Movie House. Just amazing. Keep it up, boys. Mason Hubble, Gabe Tilma, Aiden Bilodeau, they put an amazing work behind the scenes and put on a magnificent production once again this year. They will surely leave a void for Miss Williams Day next year. They found real-world application for these talents, along with their friends, the Caldwells and Sarah Tozer, filling Mr. Yannick's room with over 1,200 balloons. Yeah. If anyone is having a children's birthday party this summer, I know where you can get some decorators and a clown. Catherine Decoe displayed amazing leadership skills in art, producing high-quality works. But she realized beading was not her jam while she was helping out with Red Dress Day. But in typical Catherine fashion, She came back in spades with her all her crochet crafts. I'm sure one day we're going to see those wonderful works in a gallery someday. It was great to see people like Zamia Chinekwe truly come out of her shell. You can always tell when she's going to say something. She's going to say something when that wry smile comes across her face. And it's going to be good when it comes out. Also, shout out to all the amazing band students in this graduating class, especially the multi-talented Shelby Pohl and the amazing Oliver Bowen, Jade Jansen, Fisher Linton, Wilson McNabb, Braden DeGagne, and Jacob Gaudet. Fun fact about Jacob, he's the most emotive person you will ever meet in your life. So please make sure you catch him and Andre when you leave this afternoon and say hello. Maybe even give him a hug. He loves that. But seriously, one of my highlights this year was walking into school every morning, or most mornings, I should say, passing by the music room and hearing some truly amazing songs being belted out. My favorite, without a doubt, has to be Humanism by John Batiste and Stay Human. That's amazing. Overall, I must say, of all the grad classes that I have watched leave Bow Valley, you truly are the most recent. Yeah. That's Mr. Yannick. That was a good one. I like it. But really, this group is truly memorable. And these are just a few of the anecdotes that will continue to be shared among Bow Valley staff for the years to come. You leave behind an important legacy, and try not to dwell on the sad fact that we are never, ever, ever getting back together. Like ever. Okay? Anyway, yeah. That's two. Alrighty, let's get to the real business here. This graduating class wanted to really go back in the archives and see if we could bring back some past Bow Valley legends. But when all of them were busy, we settled on this guy. Apparently, he lives in town and had nothing going on today. He taught at Bow Valley for what seemed like an eternity, running the social department for a few years, but is a legend for what he accomplished in building the ODL and leadership programs at our school that are, frankly, the envy of most high schools in the district. Although he left us last year, his impact continues to reverberate through the hearts and minds of this graduating class. So when I heard that the students of this class had chosen this individual, it made all the sense in the world. As is his nature, he mentored both staff and students over his many years at Bow Valley, including your older brothers and sisters, probably. And it is my pleasure to introduce this year's guest speaker, Mr. Scott Thompson.
Can we give a round of applause for Mr. Lucas? What a fantastic job of emceeing. I had about 20 minutes of material just making fun of Mr. Lucas, but I figured I'll save that for later. Honored guests, remarkable colleagues, supportive families, and incredible grads, you have made it. Wow, it was so loud. All right, so we're gonna go from there, but we wanna say you've all worked hard to get here, and all of us are proud of what you've done to accomplish to get here to this day. It is a bit strange to be introduced as a guest and not as a faculty member, having taught for the last 102 years, I think, at Bow Valley. So it's odd. But it really is a privilege, and as soon as I found out your graduation date, I circled on the calendar and knew that I wouldn't miss it for the world because this is such a remarkable grad class. From the moment this group bounced into our hallways in grade 9, we just knew that this group would be special. And as a staff, we frequently talked about how we could build a school around this group of kids, a community of leaders that would continue to grow and build and foster the culture that is Bow Valley. And from our opening impressions to your final days here in grade 12, you have not disappointed, but have surpassed our expectations. You continue to inspire and give hope for the world that we now send you out into. And that alone sets you apart as a class. Now today is about celebrating different significant milestones, and we've already heard a little bit about that. And there's no doubt that today is one of those historic milestones. We have aunts and uncles, grandparents, former teachers, people who've traveled far and wide, and that's an indication of how significant it is today. But even more than that, you know it's a big day when both Bob and Ricky both wear pants to school. Let's give it up for Bob and Ricky. Well done. I think I've only seen that twice. But now the task of every grad speaker is kind of a daunting one. Each time we come, we try to attempt to inspire you with some grand vision to leave an impression that overrides 12 years of all the things we've done and said in schools and 12 years or more of parenting and hoping that somehow this moment will be the life-defining moment that you'll carry on with you into your dying days. So, you know, just a bit of pressure. But each speaker tries to craft a message that basically says, go out from the world here today and fix all the mistakes that we as the adults have already made. But today I'm asking you to do something I think is maybe more realistic, for something that hopefully will inspire you, but I know that you can do. And today I'm asking that you go and be the light that the world needs. And I know you can do this because this is already who you are and what you've already shown yourselves to be. And I'll try to give you a few examples for those of you who didn't get a chance to watch this awesome class, grade 9, 10, 11, 12. As a grad class, you have this wonderful, amazing, energetic group that you consistently brought smiles, laughter, and deep joy into our building each day. There really has never been a brighter spirit or a bigger smile to bounce into the building every day than Rachel Stewart. The world will be brighter because we have people graduating from Bow Valley High, like a Maddie Chevrier, who will bring her hard-fought wisdom to the world through psychology and counseling. The world needs the talents of an Ella Kruger in the world of healthcare, where she can leverage both her compassion and her sass, which I was the victim on many occasions. As a grad class, you have successfully navigated a world that often celebrates those who shout the loudest or applauds the most inflammatory commentators. Yet we know that it is often the quiet, the conscientious, that foster the greatest change and operate from an enduring moral compass. And as a class, you have parried the loud, angry shouts with whispers and acts of kindness and courage. And that is how you already have shared your light. One of those soulful leaders that brightens our world, of course, is a Chloe Brewster in her own quiet way. And of course, Mr. Lucas has already referred to the twins, who dress identically every day, J.C. Clawson and Joella Cotella. These are two remarkable young women who have been beacons of joy. Thanks for never being afraid of sharing your unique light. There's a common Alberta myth here that sometimes we hear and we're bombarded with on a frequent basis that suggests we just need to pull ourselves up by our bootstraps. But you have rejected that tired cliche and asked, but what about those with no shoes? And you've responded. You have actively sought out multiple opportunities to serve the less fortunate. You've consistently demonstrated a deep-seated compassion for others. You have seen need in our community and actually done something about it. You've responded with grace and service. And I can think of no better examples than the remarkable work done by Logan Vlasbaum or the quiet sacrificial choices made by Bryce and Logan Caldwell. And as a class, you are uniquely talented and gifted at seeing injustice in our world and taking measures to bring light into the dark areas. I've witnessed you helping us walk towards greater reconciliation through Red Dress Day, or leading reflective walks for the missing, murdered, and Indigenous women and girls. Powerful moments in Bow Valley's history. I think of how you've raised thousands of pounds of food for future Bobcats, given Christmas to families that had none until you gave willingly and deeply. I think of all the hundreds of kindergarten kids that you've had entertained at Bow Valley and brought joy to. I think of people like Jay Jansen, who inspire us to greater environmental responsibility. I also think of Emma Neves' work with New Leaf. You have shone a spotlight on domestic violence and created communities of passion and compassion. You already know that there are those in our society who take joy in extinguishing the light of others. They do this through the time-worn tactics of cynicism, criticism, and cruelty. And many of you have borne witness to that. You've resisted this, and I have been humbled by your involvement in the school QSA. You have created space for the marginalized in our community. You have used your light to let others know that they don't need to hide in the shadows, but you have made a spot where it's safe for them to revel in their own unique light. I think of Ben Sharkey and Savannah Gerritsen. Thanks for making Bow Valley a better place. I've also been awed by how you've stood up to injustice in the hallways and let it be known that racism has no place at Bow Valley. I think of Katie Robinson, Cassidy Swanson, and Daniel Holt hearing a comment in the hallway that you heard and holding that student to account. And in so doing, you serve notice to the broader community that intolerance has no place here. Your action lit a beacon of hope and pushed back the clouds of intolerance. Our world desperately needs what you offer, the light that you bring to push back the prevailing clouds of what we know of toxic masculinity. Masculinity that puffs its chest out and seeks to subjugate others through word and deed. Yet in our midst, in this graduating class, we have some real men, some real gentlemen, some statesmen who know that their real calling is not to subjugate but to serve. And our world will benefit from some honorable young men like a Lance Madsen, an Oliver Bowen, a Nick Stead, Sokse Hasumi, a Wilson McNabb, an Andrew Grund. I recall in grade 10, when you were in grade 10, Mr. Ball and I having a conversation about this group of young men and saying that we wanted our boys, our sons, to hang out with these boys and aspire to be like them. So to you, young men, keep holding high the torch of healthy masculinity. One does not have to look far in the sporting world to see the rise of young male athletes who strut about with an air of arrogance and entitlement. Some of these seek to minimize those that are not in their small, narrowly defined tribes. Yet in contrast, I've witnessed some of our Bow Valley athletes at the top of their game that are characterized by poise, humility, and decency. And there's no better example than future PGA golf star Zach Hademach. I also think of humble athletes that work tirelessly and embrace their supporting role on the team, like a Davis Streeter. And if we cast our gaze a little bit further, we know that several of you have shared your passion for sport and have helped to restore the roar of Bow Valley Athletics. I was able to watch Angie and Josie power through teams and then turn and help them get back up again. I also had the chance to enjoy watching Paulo Questra and Ethan Horb. Now, I think I heard something about you beating some crosstown rivals. Is that true at all? I think so. But I also, what was amazing, is I got to watch you put on a clinic against my Croxford Cavaliers. You played in an incredibly hostile environment that desperately wanted you to lose and let you know about it. Yet, you played with poise, and I was able to sit in the stands and listen to my current students, and you wowed them with your talent, but you won them over with your character, and that is far more important. That is the kind of the light that the world really needs that you uniquely bring. And I know that some of us here, all of us have faced adversity here, but there's some of you that have weathered some incredible storms of life to get here today. There are those whose light has been buffered and battered by the world. You've had to fight especially hard to protect or guard your flame. Those you've been bloodied and marred in the arena of life, yet you continue to rise and meet the challenge. And because you have had more challenges, when you walk the stage, all of us sit up a little bit more. We cheer and clap a little bit louder. Some of us even get a little catch in our throat because we know a little bit of what you have endured to be here. And there are many warriors that get to graduate here today, but a couple need a public salute. And I'm humbled by the efforts of a Piper McCormick, a Cade Fox, a Carson Gessner, an Aaliyah Bellecourt, and of course, Emma Newman. Today is a historic day, and your family and I have walked a long path together, and I am humbled to share that with you today. Grads, as you leave here today, there will be challenges, times when you want to give up, when your flame is only a flicker, an ember of hope only seems a distant memory. And in those moments, you need to remember who you really are and what you've already done and proven to be. And we know that there will be the dream killers, the naysayers, and the cynics who will seek to spread their shadow of life's disappointment and attempt to shroud your light in the heaviness that they feel. But I know you will perpetually defy these peddlers of fear and continue to be purveyors of hope, the beacons of light that you have already been from grade 9 through 12. The world needs your particular light. The world needs more Bow Valley. So go and be the light that our world so desperately needs. Thank you.
So that's why we got him. Holy. The man can deliver a speech. Thank you, Mr. T, for those nuggets of wisdom and carefully curated jokes. Now, could Miss Katie Cahoon please come to the stage and say a few words to introduce this year's valedictorian?
All right. Honorable guests, proud families, and most importantly, the remarkable graduating class of 2023. It's my distinct honor and privilege to stand before you as we celebrate the outstanding achievements of your graduating class, and in particular, to pay tribute to an individual who's earned the esteemed title of valedictorian, Jade Jansen. Not yet. My first experience of Jade was coaching her in grade 8 basketball. I was immediately impressed with her athletic abilities, but even more by her natural and exceptional sportsmanship and positivity. At our first game of the season, we were losing to the point of no longer keeping score. There was a palpable sense of preteen despair on the bench, but there was also Jade smiling her huge smile, cracking her really bad jokes, trying to cheer everyone up across the court. By the time the final whistle blew, the team was able to laugh it off and talk about what we could work on for next time, all thanks to Jade's positivity. In the words of Josie Powers, the way that Jade self-motivates inspires me to better myself on the court and in the classroom. Jade can also be found competing in curling, track, soccer, and club ringette. She's an integral part of every team she's on, both through her skill and her stellar sportsmanship. This extraordinary individual standing before us today has exemplified the very essence of academic excellence. Jade is not only an academic all-star in the classroom in terms of her grade point average, but she's also the class motivator and is always willing to help out a peer. According to Maddie Chevry, Jade never failed to keep her in check during humanities class and is a really big part of the reason she actually got through it. I had the privilege this year in seeing Jade's light shine even brighter in Bow Valley's leadership program. Jade made an everlasting impact on her incredible work, orchestrating an event that brought over 180 kindergartners from all over Cochrane to come and bond with Bow Valley. I'll always remember her proudly waving goodbye to her last bus of kinders as she completed her final leadership program of high school. Jade's an outstanding ambassador for the student leadership at Bow Valley, and her mentorship of future Bobcats will emulate for years to come. I know that one day, one of those kinders will walk back in the doors at Bow Valley as a fresh-faced grade 9, inspired to become just like that cool girl with the brown hair that they'll carry throughout their entire life. A fun yet not surprising fact about Jade is that her first word was recycle. Jade is a beacon of environmental conscientiousness, tirelessly advocating for the preservation of our planet. Jade founded the environmental not-for-profit organization, Lives with Less Plastic, at 12 years old. She strives to educate and inspire others to change the world through environmental action. Jade's educational outreach has included presenting to school groups of all ages, educating at youth and teacher conferences, creating TEDx presentations for the community and for the division, and she's even been featured in a TELUS documentary. All of this explains why her close friend Piper McCormick can count on one hand how many times she had lunch with Jade this year. In 2021, Jade's environmental work earned a prestigious Emerald Award in the youth category. Jade, I always knew I could come to you with my excitement over the discovery of a new species, or to discuss the coolest antifreeze-capable frogs, or new ideas on how to actually get my homemade vertical garden working. And you'd always match or exceed my enthusiasm. I'm really gonna miss geeking out with you. Jade excels at everything she puts her mind to and works endlessly to change the world around her, not for the accolades, but because it's the right thing to do. As Ella Kruger puts it, Jade cares deeply about everyone and everything around her and will do anything to strive for positive change. Jade will be heading to the University of Victoria in August for marine biology, marrying her love of environmental sustainability and the ocean. To our valedictorian, I offer my heartfelt congratulations. You've demonstrated unparalleled dedication, perseverance, and an unwavering commitment to excellence. I know I can speak for the entire Bow Valley High staff, saying how proud we are of you, and that we can't wait to see what your future holds, but even more, what you hold for our future. Ladies and gentlemen, Bow Valley High School's valedictorian of 2023, Jade Jansen.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. I am truly honored to be representing Bow Valley High School's graduation class of 2023. In preparation for the speech, I sat down with Ms. Galloway to do some edits, and she suggested that I could infuse some more humor into my speech. But as I explained to her, I'm not a funny person, so apologies for the lack of jokes, but that's just not my style. Truthfully, when I started writing this speech, all I could think about was the graduation speech by Jessica Stanley from the Twilight Saga Eclipse. I know I'm not just speaking for myself when I say that lots of us were obsessed with Twilight when we were younger. For those who have never seen Twilight or need a recap, in Jessica's speech, she talks about how, as you grow up, people will ask you what you want to be. She talks about how over the years, our answers will inevitably change, and when we graduate, we may not know what we want to do, and that is okay. Now, statistically speaking, we are likely to change our jobs at least 10 times before we settle down and find something that we love. Now is our time to try everything, to explore every opportunity so that maybe 10 years from now, we will know what we want to do. For all of us, this will mean reflecting on our time at Bow Valley and connecting each piece of our lives together. In grade 9, many of us were introduced to the concept of connecting the dots by Mr. Thompson. How as leaders, we need to bring together different groups of people in the school and community. We thought about questions like, how can the sports and fine arts groups come together? How can we bring together community members with students at Bow Valley? Throughout high school, all of us in one way or another have connected the dots, or rather connected with other groups in our school and or community. From that point on, connections were formed, whether we joined a new friend group, got involved in performing arts, played in band, joined a sports team, or ran leadership events. We all spent the last 4 years connecting with each other in this community, and now it's time to reflect and connect the dots within our own lives to find our true calling. So many people have helped us along our journey, whether it was teachers or school staff, coaches, community members, parents, family, the list goes on and on. Everyone has helped us become an important member of society. On behalf of everyone, thank you all so much for helping us become our best selves. As we reflect on all the people that have helped us become who we are, I challenge you all to take a moment to think of someone who has helped you along your journey. Later today, please take time to thank this person any way that you can. We have had many experiences that have helped shape us into the people we are today, and we have created so many memories. As we look back on our time together, we remember our first day of grade 9 when we were pretty much thrown into the deep end. We were nervous grade 9s, trying to figure out how to navigate our first day of high school along with all the other students. Let's just say we didn't get to experience the nice staggered entry that grade 9s do now. We all figuratively drowned our first day in the hallways. We all got to experience a fairly typical grade 9 year, whether it was week of welcome, the craziness of Halloween havoc, reindeer tag, seeing Rock of Ages, playing extracurricular sports, or band and drama, we got it all. We thought we were too cool to dress up for Halloween, so many of us wore lame costumes, or none at all, only to get to school and realize the other grades took it seriously and came in costumes from Madagascar. Gloria, Skipper, Kowalski, Private, and Rico costumes definitely showed us how Halloween was actually done at Bow Valley. But then March rolled around, and the world shut down. We had nothing to do, and we loved it at first. Let's just say when our grades couldn't drop, most of us just stopped doing schoolwork. Why put in all the work if it doesn't matter? I, on the other hand, couldn't control myself. Every bone in my body told me not to leave a single question unanswered, at length, with citations. Fast forward past all the COVID stuff, because truthfully, who really wants to hear about how we were such a resilient class in these unprecedented times? Don't get me wrong, our grade 9 and 10 experiences influenced us. But whatever, who cares, we did it, let's move on. By grade 11, we were free to live our lives again. Everything was mostly back to normal, and we allowed our memories of masking, visiting through windows, and constant hand sanitizing to fall into the background. And thus, we were once again given the opportunity to reconnect with our passions and connect with each other. We were transported back to our childhood with the Frozen play. Sports teams were back in full swing. We finally had an in-person band concert. We ran the first walk for missing and murdered Indigenous women, girls, and Two-Spirit people. All these events helped bring the community and school together in a powerful way. However, when I asked people what memories they had from grade 11, nobody could tell me anything. Truthfully, I think many of us have forgotten or blocked out what's happened from grade 9 to 11 because of how extraordinary those years were. But that's a problem for our future therapists to resolve. Now we are here. We survived our grade 12 year. Now I remember people telling me how much I would enjoy my grade 12 year, but why didn't anyone talk about how stressful it would be? Just bear with me here. There's the coursework, the diplomas, deciding what to do with your life, applying to schools, applying to scholarships, extracurriculars, and our jobs. But at the same time, we were supposed to get enough sleep, eat well, exercise, and support our mental health. Not a small feat. But we did it. We made it through these challenges that felt so insurmountable. And thankfully, throughout all of this, we also got to create some lasting memories. The Anna Green Gables production, dressing up for Halloween Havoc, memorable sporting achievements like when Bow Valley Senior Boys Basketball got their victory over Cochrane High. A never-ending band bus ride to Whistler, the exciting Tide hockey game of Cochrane Classic, a whole school round dance for Red Dress Day, and a memorable TNT send-off. We truly found our connection as a grad class this year. But now it's our time to look towards the future and use all the things we've experienced in our past to help us move forward. Whether next year you are going to post-secondary, getting a job, taking a gap year, or following your passions, we all have super exciting things coming our way. If TikTok has taught us anything, we can become famous at any moment for literally anything, or so I'm told. It's okay if we don't know what we want to do. This is our starting point to connecting the dots in our own lives. This is where our journey begins, and I can't wait to see what we accomplish next. Congratulations, Bow Valley High School's graduation class of 2023.
Thank you, Jade. That's awesome. At this time, I would ask everyone, if you are able, to please stand and remove your hats as Con Lin, Clifford, Powderface, junior, performs an honor song for the graduating class. And at this time, please no pictures as well. Thank you so much for that. That was extremely moving. At this point, I'd like to please welcome Mr. Shane Dempster, Mr. Hasiak, Miss Elliott, and the wonderful Miss Hansford and Miss Jackie Simons for the distribution of diplomas.
Lauren is the recipient of the Cochrane Home Treasury's bursary. Heather Batcher. Gershon Badesha. Keanu Barclay. Aaliyah Belcourt. Sam Bellett. Sophia Benavides Aleman. Tyler Benjamin. Peter Burning. Good job, buddy. Miranda Betterton. Tosh Big Plume. Jaden Bileski. Aiden Bilodeau. Oliver Bowen. Oliver is the recipient of the Spray Lake Sawmill Scholarship. Trinity Boyd. Justin Breton. Justin is the recipient of the Western Communities Foundation Inspirational Award. Chloe Brewster. Reed Burke. Bryce Caldwell. Yeah. Logan Caldwell.
Go, Logan!
Haley Camp. Connor Surick. Madison Cheverie. Madison is the recipient of the Kripal Kaur Dinsta Memorial Scholarship. She is also nominated for the ASAA Alberta Milk Scholarship.
Jay Chimick. Zamia Chinicky. Jack Clark. Ronan Cowie. Aiden Croft. Kenzie Cron. Paulo Cuesta. Catherine Deco. Abigail Dikos. Braden DeGagne. Taylor Deschamps. Ryby Deus. Spencer Dixon. Narelle Dolby. Jaya Donald. Owen Duncan. Oh. Emily DuPlessis. Michaela Farnham. Teo Fernandez. Reese Fisherlin. Riel Flaherty. Kayla Flindall. Maddox Fode. Cade Fox.
Thomas Fulton Bowles. Jacob Godet. Mia Jenick. Savannah Gerritsen. Carson Gessner. Sage Gibson. Olivia Giesbrecht. Andrew Grund. Nathan Hadland. Sosuke Hasumi. Zachary Hademack. Zach is the recipient of the Washburn University Golf and Academic Scholarship. Isaiah Hecht. Marcus Henderson. Jack Harrington. Aaliyah Holdway. Daniel Holt. Ethan Horb.
Thank you, Ms. Holt.
Ethan is the recipient of the Open Circle CTS Award. Colton House. Mason Hubble. Trevor Hume. Trevor is the recipient of the Chimick Family Scholarship. Jade Jansen. Jade is the recipient of the Bow Valley High School Valedictorian Award, the Premier Citizenship Award, and the Lauren Scholars Foundation. Diesel Jepps. Diesel Jepps. Amy Johnson. Evan Johnstone.
Anthony Giuliano. Annalisa Gorilla. Anton Kakwitz-Berspa. Liam Kasapchuk. Caitlin Kelly. Anson Kyle. Leanna Klamberg. Jace Klassen. Joel Katala. Bradley Kosak. Bradley is the recipient of the Power Pilot Scholarship Program through the Air Cadets. Aiden Coyota. Marco Crisanda. Safrina Croker. Ella Kruger. Matthew Lambert. Austin LaRocque. Keelan Larwood. Austin Legault. Belle Levisky. Fisher Linton. Angelina Long. Tegan Lord. Charlie Loveridge. Ashish Madan.
Andre Maddox. Lance Madsen. Jamie Mark. Keenan Marquardt. Faith Marsh. Yeah. Phoenix Marsh. Haley Martins. Brooke McBride. Piper McCormick. Piper is the recipient of the Bearspaw Benevolent Foundation Bursary, and she's nominated for the Schulich Leader Scholarship. Megan McGregor. Roka McKenney. Caden McMartin. Wilson McNabb. Wilson is the recipient of the Cochrane and District Chamber of Commerce Scholarship. He's also nominated for the ASAA Alberta Milk Scholarship. Owen Myers. Emma Neve. Emma Newman. Peyton Niemi. Eli Obrey. Jessica O'Neill. DJ Olimpo. Aiden Allerhead. Ashley Oram. Olivia Osborne. Olivia is the recipient of the Spray Lake Sawmill Scholarship.
Tristan Owen. Hennis Patel. Hennis is the recipient of the Cochrane and Area Humane Society Scholarship, as well as the Interpipeline Discovery Award. Shelby Pohl. Daria Polianska. Daria is a recipient of the Kirpal Kaur Dinza Memorial Scholarship. Josie Powers. Josie is the recipient of the Bow Valley Class Act Scholarship. Connor Priest. Nyla Radesh. Keith Radford. Fernanda Rivera Lara. Dylan Roblard.
That suit always makes me smile.
Katie Robinson. Neo Roth. Melvin Simano. Cohen Schumlich. Benjamin Sharkey. Grace Sylvester. Grace is the recipient of the Cochrane Area Humane Society Scholarship and the Cochrane Lions Club Scholarship. Mavi Sokolowski.
That seemed a lot more complicated than me.
Nicholas Stead. Rachel Stewart. Hannah Stickle. Ethan Sterling. Ethan is the recipient of the Western Communities Foundation Western Inspirational Award. Brooklyn Strozik. Davis Streeter.
Cassidy Swanson. Cassidy is the recipient of the Binder Rise Up Scholarship and the Chimick Family Scholarship. Fjord Sword. Ethan Schweitzer. Ethan is the recipient of the Rotary Club of Cochrane U-START Bursary. Kirsten Tannis. Kira Therien. Abigail Thomas. Sierra Thomas. Harry Thorne. Gabriel Tilma. Jack Toombs. Sarah Tozer. Molly Tuck. Gavin Van Dyke. Megan Verart. Okay. Caitlin Viano. Logan Blasblom. Michaela Warren. Braden Watt. Levi Wedderburn. Quentin Wedderburn. Aaron Welmer. Sydney Whale. Haley Wilbur. Lucy Williamson.
Teague Winters. Carson Wright. Zach Wright. Natasha Yarmachuk. Princess Nadine Ilarde. Joelle Zylstra.
Sorry, Mr. Hasiuk definitely messed it up.
Hey, stop. Oh, there it is. Okay. Got it.
Okay, at this point, could I please have all the students from Stony Nakota Nation line up on the side of the stage? Hello? I would also welcome the representatives from Stony Nakota Nation to the stage to honor their graduates. We are honored to welcome Elder Doreen Kukwitz from Good Stony Nation to begin the presentations. Right now? Chief Aaron Young is going to speak for a little bit.
Amawastino Ishnish Yiska Hamchata. Ingechane, was the one. Uncontinued, I yanked in the Hamtrahange, Nangu, Taruskarun chahaini chi baengiajun washabicha yainichia ngahamba ne hotejainde nin ngabonde nechi hamine ko opin chagine warno isnies epelo de daha yidawne ayabikti je yebihwan. At this time it gives me great pleasure. Can I have the 2023 class of 2023 please stand up? Ladies and gentlemen, we are proud people, all of us. I'm standing up here with leaders. These young women and men are the leaders of all of us. The future looks bright, and I feel proud to be standing up here with them. Let's give them a round of applause. As we lead our lives with the vision that we have before us, we hold the integrity, the humbleness of the families that we stand here with, the mothers, the teachers, the advisors, leadership. We're all here to for you, 2023 students. Don't forget that we are here and we'll always be here. And the light that is shining before you looks bright. Don't fall back, don't set back, because the word test in itself goes a long way. When we were kids, all of you, when you were kids, you tested your parents. You tested everybody amongst us in the families. But with that testing came patience. Patience brings honor. Patience brings integrity. And at the end of the day, graduation. You guys did it. Congratulations, 2023. On behalf of the Stony Tribe, we are now honored to stand up here to give feathers and blankets to our children. The honor song that was sung earlier today, that was for you. When we sing that song, we don't do it on any occasion. We sing it with pride to show and to come together to recognize and to realize that our future looks bright. And today we will be giving feathers and the blanket that we will be honored to share and some of the teachings that we have heard and so forth. As we've been taught, when you go in life, you win, and then you learn. There's never losing. In school, you learn. And then you get tested. In life, you get tested, and then you learn. But what you learn here in high school with the teachings of your family's heritage and so forth, you guys will all look good. You guys will succeed. First Nations, we're all proud of our integrity and our culture, just like all of us. We're all human. We're all a family. So with that, I'd like to say congratulations. I'm proud of you. Yes.
From Bearspaw Nation, Anton Kakwitz Bearspaw. From Chiniki Nation, Mr. Tyler Benjamin, Zamia Chinikwe, and Jamie Mark. From Good Stony Nation, Mr. Cade Fox. Mr. Colton House. From Sutina, First Nation, Tosh Big Plume. And on behalf of Bow Valley High School, I'd like to offer some tobacco to Elder Doreen Kukwitz. You guys can sit down. No? Thanks. Thank you. So, I can clearly see we went over time, and Mr. Devine is getting a little thirsty. So, they only gave me a few minutes, so I'm going to try to, you know, not keep you waiting any longer. But before I forget, days like this truly don't happen without some incredible people. So, with that, I would like us all to thank the incredible grad committee, but I want to highlight a few members, like Ms. Holliday, Ms. Stark, Ms. LaFond, Ms. Hansford, Mr. Rasperich, and Ms. Elliott for their tireless work. So, we come now to the part where I have to be a little serious and saccharine. Thanks, Mr. Millings, for that word. Didn't even know about it. Ms. Galloway, Mr. Yannick, and Mr. Millings all played a huge role, actually, in crafting this entire speech, so I can't take all the credit. Okay, so give them up for that. Okay. Back to me now. Class of 2023, this day marks the end of your chapter of this educational journey. I remember the first day this class of graduates walked in nervously into the halls of Bow Valley. I remember this because it was my first day as well. And the feeling that we all shared was mutual. Since that day, the individuals seated before us have gone through transformational change, overcome challenges of sizable proportions, and experience triumphs that will be treasured for a lifetime. As you embark on your new adventures, take a moment to acknowledge the footprints you leave behind and be proud of the fact that you are excellent stewards and ambassadors for Bow Valley. You started this high school journey with the world seemingly normal, only to have the metaphorical rug pulled from under you. You handled that transition to online with grace and grit, demonstrating the resiliency we've come to expect from this group. You made the best of the situation that nobody knew how to navigate, including us teachers. When we all came back in person, you took on the responsibility to adapt to a new normal, and once again, you showed your determination to make the best of an uncertain time. You stepped up and you became leaders to the new grade nines, who were even more confused than you were when you walked in, showcasing once again what makes this class of graduates special. Fast forward 2 years, and here you are, not bent, not broken, but standing tall next to your fellow graduates and your families, all of whom are so incredibly proud of the people you've grown into. In life, every single person has to overcome challenges and push through that initial pain. But it is through this act that we learn who we are and how much fortitude and strength we truly have. Like the old adage says, it's not the destination, but the journey and the people we meet along the way that mold who we are. So I want to close with these two comments. First, I want you to all take a look around at the individuals who have brought you to this point, the coaches, the amazing support staff, the teachers, the admin, your extended family members, your grandparents, and of course, parents and guardians. Each person on that list has contributed in some way or another to the person you are today. I want you to find one of them when this is all over. And I want you to thank them and tell them exactly how much they mean to you. Second, I want you to always remember that empathy, compassion, and kindness are far more evolved human traits than fear, small-mindedness, entitlement, and intolerance. Because by nature, we are suspicious of things we do not know. By showcasing empathy, compassion, and kindness, we go against our primal instincts, and every day, we must make our choice. As you go forward, I want you to always think about how we must all work together to make this world of ours a more inclusive place where everyone, and I mean everyone, regardless of creed, color, socioeconomic status, or sexual orientation, is always treated with dignity and respect. Remember, the kindest person in a room is generally the smartest. I have immense confidence that this 2023 class has a lot of smart individuals who will choose kindness wherever life takes them. Lastly, thank you again to this graduating class for this incredible honor. It is one I will not forget, and I will carry with fond memories of our time together. And as always, go Cats! So now, we're done the formal part. We're going to do the recessional, okay? The recessional, it's like my hairline, it's receding. We're gonna recede back away. Mrs. Katie Cahoon, sorry, and Mr. Taylor Grant will now lead the graduates. After the recessional, just so we're clear, all scholarship recipients and donors, please meet Ms. Bielert by the stage to receive and chat with your benefactors. Right. So I guess we'll do the, everybody stand up. Graduates. Well, you guys can stand up too, I guess. You know, you gotta take pictures. So at this point, I guess we'll do a countdown, if that's customary. And then we'll toss the hats. So before we do that, let's make sure mom, dad, and everybody, all the family members got their phones out. And I'm also gonna take my phone out so I can do a selfie, oh gosh, a selfie with this crew. Okay, we ready? So 3, 2, 1, right? Okay, ready? Simple instructions. 3, 2, 1. So, congratulations, class of 2023. And remember, as Riri would say, shine bright like a diamond. They were supposed to play this song.
Shine bright like a diamond. Find light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky. I knew there would become one right away. Oh, right away. At first sight, I felt the energy of sunrise. Life inside. So shine bright tonight.
the universe as we moonshine and Mali. Feel the warmth, we'll never die. We're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star, I see a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky. At first sight, I felt the energy of surrender. I saw the life inside of you. Shine bright tonight. You and I, we're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Eye to eye, so alive. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Shining bright like a diamond. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Shining bright like a diamond. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. So shine bright.